In this problem, we're given a 10 kilogram block sitting on a smooth inclined plane. And initially it's not going anywhere because it's held in place with a string, and that string is parallel to the surface of the ramp. Then for the second part of the problem, we cut the string and we ask, how fast does the block accelerate down the ramp? So we start the problem by putting in the weight vector, so the force of gravity, which is straight down. The magnitude is given by mg. You might want to go ahead and put a number on that, as long as there's room in your diagram. So 10 times 9.8 is 98 newtons. Then I want to decompose this force of gravity into perpendicular and parallel components. And one of the key points with decomposing these weight vectors on an inclined plane is that the angle of incline is exactly the same as the angle between the weight vector and the perpendicular. And I'll post a link to the video where I prove this real quick. This means our perpendicular component of gravity is given by the adjacent side of this right triangle. So we use the cosine function for that. That's mg cosine theta. But we already know mg is 98. So 98 cosine 35. And provided there's room in the diagram, there's no problem with putting the numbers in as we go. And I get 80.3 newtons. For the perpendicular piece. So that's how hard gravity is pulling the block into the surface. The block won't go through the surface, of course, because a normal force will oppose that. But that doesn't matter for any of the questions we're asked in this problem, so I'm not even going to draw the normal force. Now the opposite side on this triangle, that's given by the sine function, and then we're going to move that to where it's attached to the center of our object. It's given by mg sine theta. That's 98 sine 35. And that comes out to approximately 56.2 newtons. All right, so when we see an inclined plane problem, we almost just do that decomposition reflexively before we even read what the question is. If I now read part A, I'm asked for the initial tension in the string. And so if I go ahead and put this force vector into the force diagram, there's the tension. A tension is a force exerted by a string. And we know from the way this problem is set up, the object is not going to move. It's tied in place with that string. That means there's zero acceleration parallel to the surface of the ramp. And that means the forces are balanced. In other words, the net force is zero on this object. So we get our answer immediately. If the forces are balanced in that parallel direction, it means the magnitude of the tension is equal to 56.2 newtons. And we're done with part A. In part B, we cut the string and the block begins to slide down the ramp. So this tension force is gone. And the only force acting parallel to the surface is now this 56.2 newton force pulling down the ramp. So we can apply Newton's second law in this parallel direction and say that A is equal to F over M. There's only a single force acting here, and that's 56.2 newtons. And the mass of the block is 10 kilograms, and I get an acceleration of 5.62 meters per second squared. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.